Is Metro Manila prepared to ease lockdown restrictions? All 17 mayors in the Philippine capital region believe so, as they back a recommended shift from a modified enhanced to a general community quarantine or GCQ by June 1st. This means more businesses and modes of transport will be allowed to resume operations. Airlines in Manila's main gateway, Naia, are ramping up efforts to adhere to stricter health standards. For Air Asia and Cebu Pacific, these include contactless booking, self-check-in kiosks, and installment of plastic barriers between the airline staff and passengers. Flight attendants of Philippine Airlines will also be wearing a full protective personal equipment.
Hanggat maaari kasi, kailangan po yung pasahero mismo yung magsustow ng kanilang hand carry baggage para hindi po hawakan ng ibang tao ang kanilang bagahe.
Ang ating mga pasahero, pag binili na po nila yung kanilang ticket, they will be provided options. Tatanungin sila, would you like to sit in the cabin where social distancing is observed, or the cabin where individual seats are seated together, are all together? So we will provide our passengers these options.
Railway authorities also preparing to accommodate more people returning to work. At the Line 3 of Manila's Metro Rail Transit System, or MRT3, the trains will be disinfected twice every trip. Pregnant women, as well as persons below 21 years old and senior citizens, will be barred from entering the stations.
Ang paghahanda naman po namin ay nakasalalay din po sa guidelines ng IATF. Nandiyan po yung social distancing sa pagpila. At pagpasok po ng mga pasahero natin ay kukunan po ng ano yan, ng temperatura, ng thermal scanner natin.
But only 153 passengers will be allowed to board every train set, a sharp decline from 1,200 passengers. This poses a problem for commuters as the Metropolitan Manila Development Authority is keen on barring public buses and jeepneys from operating under the GCQ. The agency says monitoring these modes of transport will be difficult for authorities.
Wag na lang po muna sana yung buses natin at jeepneys kasi mahirap po i-control dito yung physical distancing. Alam naman po natin ang jeep natin at bus, stop and go yan, ano? Sasakay, magbababa. So medyo mahirap po i-monitor hanggat hindi pa po natin nadidisiplina yung ating mga kababayan sa tamang pagsakay at pagbabapos.
MMDA General Manager Jojo Garcia clarifies that recommendation exempts point-to-point buses, which he says are easier to monitor. He adds taxi cabs, ride-hailing services, and tricycles may resume operations once Metro Manila is placed under GCQ. For the Employers Confederation of the Philippines, public transport limitations are among the reason small businesses will have a difficult time adjusting to the East lockdown rule.
90% of our enterprises are micro. They are not the ones who have a facility for services. Many of them are just watching on the sideline what they can do. Aside from the problem on shuttle, they have a problem also on there are things that they have to, protocols that they have to conform with, buying supplies, that for protection of the employees, the spacing they have to prepare in their office and or in factories. So that needs a lot of preparation.
The Philippine Chamber of Commerce and Industry and the Makati Business Club welcome the shift, but they call on government not to be complacent about the threat of the coronavirus.
We cannot totally eliminate the risk, but what we can do is we can try and at the same time maintain the DOH standards of safe distancing, face mask, and so on and so forth, and do our best to make sure that we have the consumer confidence.
Interior Chief Eduardo Año says President Duterte will decide on the fate of the Metro Manila lockdown by Thursday or Friday. Pia Gutierrez, ABS-CBN News.